Let's go! Are you ready? Are you ready for a new Bitcoin all-time high today? I'm just going to say it straight. I'm going to say that I believe that Bitcoin is due for a massive pump. And today we're going to talk about that. We're talking about Ethereum, Cardano, we're talking about BNB, general stuff you need to know about in the crypto space. And welcome back, everybody. My name is Cristiano, bringing you cryptocurrency videos every day. If you're new to this channel, make sure to subscribe and activate the bell right now. Okay, let's get right into the Bitcoin price. And throughout the last couple of weeks, I have been telling you why I believe that we are going to now have a big pump, because I saw that the consolidation that we've been having, I felt it was enough. And I think that we were due for a big pump, especially from this orange box here at $50,000, shooting up from this very convincingly, and then, you know, shooting up towards our previous all-time high again. I believe that we are going to make a new all-time high very soon. What we need to do really is just to break this level here at $61,014. If we do that convincingly, I think that $68,500 is going to be reached pretty quick. So we will see about that. We are on the 4-hourly, but pay attention to this orange line at $61,000. This is key. We've been consolidating right under. I mean, normally when you get to a new previous all-time high like this, you see a big fat rejection, but we did see that. But look at this. You had a decent rejection, but then very convincing pump here. And now, again, consolidation below the previous all-time high. That is a very good sign. So there's one thing we need to talk about. I need to make you aware of the CME gap that has been formed right now. So you do have a CME gap between 58,795, because that is where CME closed on Friday. And now when it opened up, obviously the Bitcoin price was higher. So you have about, almost $1,000 as a gap here. Are we going to go down and fill this? Maybe. Now, I wouldn't be too worried if we actually do that. If we go back to Bitcoin, that would mean that we were going to go down, not even down to this orange box, just break this level. And really, that still keeps the bullish trend intact. So let's say we were to have a small little rejection here. We go down to this orange box. And then we go up again. Not too bad, but I think that it's actually also a high probability that we do not fill this CME gap. So yes, very exciting times. I hope that you are ready for what's to come, because it is going to be volatile. Also, the P cycle top indicator has actually crossed. I'm of course talking about this one right here. Previously, you had that cross. And also you had a correction or the start of a bear market once you saw that cross. I don't think that this is going to be the case now. I still believe that we have more upside left. So let's see what's going to be right. Satoshi stacker or the P cycle top indicator. And guys, if you want to start trading yourself and get nice bonuses, you can get $200 on Bybit, $200 on Femex as well. If you want to apply as a translator and go full-time crypto, make sure to use this link. Make sure to take advantage of that and also watch my trading tutorial at the end of this video. So yeah, Bitcoin looking increasingly bullish here. By the time you watch this video, you probably know if we were able to break this and shoot up or not, or if we got that rejection. Just know this. If we do get that rejection, watch this orange line here at 57,800, the orange box, because this is usually a good time to load up if we actually get down here. I want to go back in history a bit, because in November of 2020, this was pretty much when I started my YouTube channel, a bit like 1 month in or so. And I talked about a fractal, which was actually given to me by Will Park. And we compared gold during this period to Bitcoin during this period. And this is not even when Bitcoin had reached its previous all-time high yet. I think we were at maybe $10,000 or so here. And we were comparing this fractal, and we were anticipating that this could actually be likely. And yeah, now, a couple of months later, 5 months later, it seems like this fractal was actually pretty accurate. Hey, let me know in the comment section if you were around in November and you actually saw us talking about this. Very cool. Let's talk about Ethereum. Ethereum also looking very bullish. Right now, we are about to also break our previous all-time high here, $2,200. Next target is all the way up at $2,500. So pay attention to that on Ethereum. And look, I got bombarded yesterday. We need to talk about Cardano, but I got bombarded yesterday saying, people saying, thank you so much for pumping Cardano. Thank you so much for actually making this happen. I was like, are you crazy? What are you talking about? And then I went to the Cardano chart and I looked at this. And then I saw what people were saying. They were pointing me towards my video yesterday. And let me just show you what I talked about in yesterday's video. I mean, at this point, it's pretty much speculation because it's very clear that something is influencing Cardano very heavily. But if that entity, for whatever reason, decides to stop doing that, I think that Cardano is due for a big pump up to $1.46 here. That's what I'm expecting. But again, this is completely out of our hands. But if whoever is suppressing Cardano right now is watching this video, yeah. I think that it's time now. It's time for Cardano to have another big pump here to $1.45. Let's do it. So yeah, all Cardano holders, if you want to thank me for pumping your bag, you got the Cardano donation address down in the description. And that was, of course, a joke. But yeah, nice little pump here on Cardano. And are we going to go up here at $1.46? I think that this is inevitable at this point. I think that we are going to do that. And yeah, we're seeing us very convincingly shoot up from this orange line. And now we are finally leaving the stablecoin shackles here. And cool, let's see how it goes. BNB. Now, BNB is very interesting. All-time high after all-time high. I've been so bullish on BNB. Congratulations to everyone who have been following me on BNB since I started talking about them at $20, actually. That's almost a 60x, completely insane. No, sorry, obviously it's only a 30x, only a 30x, right? But BNB is looking very bullish still. And look, okay, I get it. It's centralized, it's this and that. But what I will say is BNB is the only way for normal people. You know, people who are trading with a couple of $1,000s to be able to yield farm and do all of these cool things, utilize many dApps, because let's face it, you cannot do it on Ethereum. And if, you know, I'm all about things being fair. I'm all about everyone getting the same opportunities. And if they are able to yield farm and do all of these cool things on the Binance Smart Chain, I don't have a problem with it, okay? And then, of course, there's massive, massive price appreciation on BNB recently, so that doesn't hurt either. But I think that BNB is still going to continue to do well. You got the next targets here at $613. You got $774. That's pretty much those. And I think these are based on the Fibonacci here. So we do the Fibonacci on the recent trend. And you can see that those levels are aligning with my orange levels. So pay attention to these levels. They are going to be important. You can see that this level was important here. This was also a Fibonacci level. This one at 346. And now we got 615 again. And we got 776. And look at this. BNB is at, what is it? Almost $90 billion in market cap. Completely insane. And it only needs to do a 3x compared to Ethereum to surpass it, which is insane. But is it unlikely? I don't know, guys. I don't know. I mean, it has more users than Ethereum already. It has a lot of stuff going for it. And then it's backed by the biggest ecosystem in the world. Guys, if you want to know more about BNB and the Binance Smart Chain, make sure to take a look at my recent video posted only 13 hours ago on this channel. And let's go back to Bitcoin just a tiny bit, because I want to look at this wedge, if we have broken out of it. Obviously, we have not. So let's go to the daily. This wedge is something you need to pay attention to also, because if we reach $63,000, at the current point, we are going to break this wedge, which is going to propel Bitcoin even higher. So that's the wedge. We've been talking about pretty much everything I want to cover today. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video.